Hey guys, welcome to the engineering world. Here is the pre-mock test series 1 solution for GATE, SSCJ, ISAAC skill exams, etc. Guys, subscribe our channel and give me the support. Here is the explain the solution for machine design mock test 18th April 2020. You can attempt this mock test at any time and link is present in the description box. Here is the first question. Design of shafts made of brittle material is based on first Gauss theory, Rankine theory, Sanfilippo theory, von Mises theory. The correct answer is Rankine theory. Actually, for brittle material, Rankine theory is applicable. Then the next question is, in a band break, the coefficient of friction is 0.35. The width of band is 70 mm and diameter is 75 mm. And the angle of overlap of the band on the drum is 180 degree. The normal pressure between drum and lining is limited to 0.3 MPa. The tension on the tight side is. For calculating the tension in the tight side, we required only normal pressure, width and radius of the band. Here, normal pressure is given 0.3 MPa. Diameter 75, so R is equal to 37.5 mm and width B 70 mm is given. The formula is tension on the tight side is equal to P into R into B. Please note down this formula, pressure into R into B, where R into B is a elemental area. Actually R into B into there is a delta theta, but delta theta is very small, so we neglected P R B. So by calculating we will get 787.5. Then the next question, which of the following is correct? Here, the line A, it is a yield line, okay? Then the B is the Gerber's line, Gerber's parabola, okay? This is the yield line, A is the, then the this B is the Gerber's parabola, that is Gerber's line. Then this is the, this straight line is a Goodman's line, that is representing C, and this is the Soderbergh line, that is D. So correct answer is B, Gerber's line. This is matching, so correct answer is B, Gerber's line. Then the next question is, a journal bearing of 45 mm diameter and 55 meter length rotating at 1150 rpm and carries a load of 1.2 kN. The lubricant used has viscosity of 0.025 Pascal/s. So radial clearance is 49.7 micrometer. What is Sommerfeld number? Here N is given 1150 rpm. In Sommerfeld number, we have to find in revolution per second. So divided by 60, we will get 19.166. Diameter is 45 mm. We will convert it into meter. So 0.045. Radius d by 2, that is 0.0225. Radial clearance here given 49.7 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter. We also converted meter. Then coefficient mu 0.025 and W, that is load acting 1200 newton. Then Sommerfeld number is equal to R upon C square into mu n by P. R is a radius, okay, radius of that shaft. Then C is a radial clearance square. Here I am showing R is a shaft radius, C is the radial clearance, mu is the absolute viscosity of the lubricant, which is given in Pascal second. Then n is the speed of rotating shaft in revolutions per second. Revolution per second. And P is the load per unit of projected bearing area, that is pressure. By putting all the values in formula, we will get 20.25.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. This is the most important question for in the GATE point of view as well as IAS point of view. Then, fifth one, in the bolt of uniform strength, these are the options. Actually, bolt of uniform strength has core diameter of thread is equal to the diameter of the shank of the bolt. here is I will explain the what is meant by uniform strength bolt and how it is a core diameter of 3D is equal to diameter of shank of the bolt. Just a minute. Here there is a shank diameter as well as thread diameters are equal. The bolt of uniform strength means there is a same value of stress across the area all over the bolt. Got it? Same value of stress across the area of all over the bolt. That is, if we calculate in the shank portion, it is same stress. In thread portion, it is same stress. That is uniform strength. Hence, when shank diameter is reduced to the core diameter of the bolt, that is this diameter, shank diameter, I am showing, is equal to the bolt core diameter of the thread, then they have same area throughout the bolt. Hence, it is called as bolt of the uniform strength. There is another method by drilling the hole. I will explain it in the machine design 2021 GATE and IES lecture. Then the next question is, in a fillet welded joint, the weakest area of the weld is, weakest area you have to find. Here I am drawing the pair. This is the weld and there is a line to the 45 degree to the horizontal, and this line represent the weakest area. This area is means into the mobile, okay, into the your screen, this line is, this area plane is weakest, and this is known as throat. Then the next question is, on the motors with low starting torque, the type of clutch used is to be, it is a simple and it's centripetal clutch. I am giving here the types and uses of clutches, just overview. First is centripetal clutch. It is used in low powered electric motors and mopeds. Remember this, centripetal clutch, low powered electrical motors and mopeds. Then jog clutch, suitable for low speeds only and used in rolling mills. Just take a screenshot of this, it is very useful. Then multiple clutch, it acquires less space and used in bikes and scooters. Then single plate friction clutch, it is used, acquires larger space and used in trucks. Please note, take the screenshot of that. Then the 8th one, anti-friction bearings are, actually the answer is ball and roller bearing. In ball and roller bearing, there is contact area is less and hence there is friction is also less. Hence these are also known as anti-friction bearing. Then the next question is, removal of material particles from the raceway of the rolling contact bearing is a kind of failure of the bearing known as, its answer is spalling. Actually it occurs due to the impact and corrosion, and in this small pieces break out from the metal body. To avoid it, we have to increase the surface hardness as well as we have to design with a proper criteria. Then the next question is, for a member under fatigue loading, the minimum and maximum stress developed at a critical point is 100 MPa and 250 MPa respectively. Endurance, yield and ultimate strength are given 300, 500 and 700. Factor of safety using Gerber's criteria. This is important, Gerber's criteria. Many students did mistake in this question. So please be careful. Sigma max given 250 MPa, sigma mean is given 100 MPa, endurance strength 300 MPa, yield strength 500 MPa, ultimate strength 700 MPa. Okay, sigma I, sigma amplitude, sigma max minus sigma mean divided by 2, that is 750 MPa. Okay, then sigma mean is equal to sigma max plus sigma mean whole divided by 2, that is 175 MPa. Then by Gerber's equation, here factor of safety into sigma A upon sigma C plus factor of safety into sigma M upon sigma UT bracket square is equal to 1. Here sigma A represent amplitude, stress amplitude. Okay, then sigma E, it represent the endurance strength. Then sigma m means stress and SUT. SUT ultimate strength, ultimate tensile strength. This is the formula. By putting all the values in this formula, we get factor. Here is a square. Remember this. This is an important point, square. And here we did factor of safety also square. So we get factor of safety 2.47. This is an important question. Please note down that. Then stress concentration is caused due to. Actually, what is meant by stress concentration? Stress concentration is the localization of high stresses due to irregularities present in the component or abrupt changes in cross section of the component. Let me explain here. Here is the one component. Stresses acting are like this. If we break this in the middle, then also stresses are like same as above. Just let me draw. If there is a hole, okay, then at that middle portion, if there is middle portion is hole, then stresses are like this. But at hole, at the hole, there are maximum stresses, and this concept is known as stress concentration. Okay, there are many reasons for this. And in this question, the reason for stress concentration is variation in the properties of material in a member. Okay, B is the correct one. Variation in the properties of material in a member. Then the next question is, if load on a ball is half, it slides. Actually, it is from bearing. Actually, L10 life is equal to C upon P cube, C, where C is dynamic load capacity, P is bearing load. So here life is inversely proportional to cube of the load. So load is halved, life becomes 8 times of the original. What it? Life inversely proportional to the cube of the load. So load half, L 8 times. Answer is increased 8 times. Then the next question is, a clutch has outer and inner diameters 100 mm and 40 mm respectively. Assuming a uniform pressure, remember uniform pressure of 2 MPa and coefficient of friction of inner diameter 0.4. Torque capacity, we have to find torque capacity. Given D0, outer diameter 100 mm, that is 0.1 meter, inner 40 mm, that is 0.04 meter, sorry, pressure 2 MPa. Is equal to 2 × 10⁶ pascal, mu 0.4. here uniform pressure theory is given. So formula for torque carrying capacity of the clutch is pi by 12 into p pressure into mu into in bracket d0 cube minus di cube. By putting, we get 196 Nm. These are machine design problems, are just formula based questions. Then the next question is, the dynamic load carrying capacity of bearing is 22 kN. The maximum radial load it can sustain to operate at 600 revolutions per minute for 2000 hours is. Here, the life is given in the hours. We have to convert it into the L10 life, that is million revolutions life. Here is the formula for L10 life. 60 into N, where N is in the RPM. Into LH by 10⁶. By putting values, we get L10 life, that is life in million revolutions, as 72 million revolutions. Then just we used a formula, L10 is equal to C by P cube. By putting values, we get P is equal to 5.29 kN. Just simple. Then the next question is, the permissible stress in fillet weld is 100 Newton per meter square. The fillet weld has equal leg lengths of 15 mm each. Allowable shearing load on weldment per centimeter length of the weld is, per centimeter we have to find, okay, here is the formula, F is equal to 0.707 into S into L into tau permissible stress. So given S leg length 15 mm, here L is equal to 1 cm, that is per centimeter length is equal to 10 mm, okay. Tau given 100 newton per mm square. By putting these values in the equation, we get 10.6 kilonewton. Just simple. All machine design problems are just formula based. The next is, to avoid self engagement in a cone clutch, semi cone angle is always kept. This is a straightforward question, remember this. Greater than angle of static friction. Semi cone angle is always kept greater than angle of static friction to avoid self engagement in cone clutch. Then the next is, if the ratio of diameter of rivet hole to the pitch of the rivet is 0.25, then tearing efficiency of the joint is. We have to point tearing efficiency. Let these are the, this is the riveted joint, these are the rivets. Here F is applied load, it is pulling, and due to applied load there is a tearing, okay, tearing, you know, tearing of that plate. And the tearing efficiency is equal to tearing failure strength divided by strength of the plate. Then what is meant by tearing failure strength? Actually tearing failure strength is the P minus T into sigma T, where P is the pitch, okay, pitch distance between that rivets, D diameter of the hole of the rivet, T thickness of the plate. Then we get sigma T get cancel, eta is equal to P minus D by P. By putting we get 0.75. remember P minus D upon P, just formula P minus D by P, okay. Then the next question is, the SN curve for steel becomes asymptotic nearly at. This is the SN curve. SN curve means number here 10 raised to 6 cycle. It is asymptotic at 10 raised to 6 cycles. Then the next question, in the formulation of Lewis equation for toothed gearing, it is assumed that tangential tooth load F acts on the, here according to Lewis assumption, he considered it as a cantilever beam, fixed beam like a cantilever beam, and here is a load acting, okay, at the end, that is load is acting at the tip of the tooth, okay, got it. Tip of the tooth, okay. Then the next question is, in a journal bearing, the diameter of journal is 0.15 meter, its speed is 900 rpm, and the load on the bearing is 40 kN. Consider coefficient of friction 0.0072. Heat generated is given by mu wv, v is the velocity in meter per second, that is v is equal to, we know that r into omega, omega is 2 pi n by 60. We also know that r, okay, because diameter is given. By putting values we get v is equal to 7.068 meter second. In heat generated, just put all the values, mu is given, w is given, we found that we get here v meter per second, we get the value 2.03, that is 2 kW. In this way we conclude our this chapter. Give me the support, I will give my the best. Subscribe our YouTube channel and also join our Telegram channel. Thanks, keep going on, just study, all the best.